Good morning. Thank you guys so much for all the birthday wishes. And I was thinking about whether I did a video or not for my birthday, but you know what? We are on a mission. So I am here because I want you guys to keep going for National Recruiting Week. And we are on a plan to meet a goal. As many of you know, my plan is 5 recruits a day. And I'm gonna work all the way till the end, all the way until Sunday. That's my goal. So I'm combining field time with social media and a combination of just everything, calling leads, following up with past events, old leads that I generated in past events. And the reason why I'm doing these videos for National Recruiting Week is because I want to get you guys excited so that you can continue the cycle until Sunday. This is going to generate a momentum because the purpose of Recruiting Week, National Recruiting Week, is to teach you consistency, to build momentum, to focus on an activity which is recruiting so that you can continue to do the same throughout your career, whether you are with Avon or not. I hope that everyone is here with Avon. But if you're not, accept our advice and just work your business consistently. I want to share some things with you. And as I look back at the many years when I first got started, I look at the things that we have done and accomplished, and we have done the things that we do to grow our business consistently. We have been doing many, many years of building consistently. We have never stopped. And I want to show you something because this year we're going to be at conference again. The company invited us to co-host a seminar. It's the Family Affairs Seminar. And we're going to be there with Karen Smith, and also Ivana and Sandra and Randy Smith. It's going to be a great, and Renee Habley, and she's going to be the moderator. And it's amazing that we are able to represent the company this way, and all that is because of consistency. We're also going to be presenters at the Time to Shine at the Product Expo, and I want to show you our first conference. This is a plaque that Avon gave us back in 2009, and we have been part of Avon conferences since 2009. Every time they have a conference, they choose the people who are consistent, the people who are showing commitment to the company to present and represent the company. So I would like for you guys to look at your history building your business and ask yourself the question, have you been consistent with what you have been doing? It's not about going out this week and working the business this week, and next week comes and you're not going to continue. The routine continues to happen, and you go back to the same exact behaviors that you were doing all this time. So I would like for you guys to take this week and reflect on what it is that you have done in the past, then forget about it. If it's not consistency or consistently forget about it and start a brand new beginning. Success doesn't happen by luck. A lot of people think that we got here by luck. We got here because we work hard. We work hard every day. We devote time for our business. We don't work for the company, we work for ourselves. We represent Avon, the products, and we are independent, completely independent representatives. That means, when you talk about independent, means that you are taking a product and a marketing plan that has already been developed by Avon and using that product to make money. And that's what we do with Avon. If something is not going well, or you had a setback, with a customer or your team performance, whatever it is that's happening, remember, this is your business. Be strong enough to understand that whatever happens is because it happens, and you just can't quit. You can't say, I'm not working anymore, for the company. No, you're not working for the company, you're working for yourself. And the minute that you decide that it's enough, that's when everything is gonna go back to zero and rebuilding again. I've seen many situations where a representative would say, okay, no, I'm going to this other company because it's gonna be better. It doesn't matter what company you represent or what company you choose to work with, they're all the same. You know, there's ups and downs everywhere you go. So make the commitment, especially this week as we start, as we continue the cycle until Sunday of recruiting, make the commitment this week to stick to your guns and continue after this week with your field activities. As I said in many videos, I recommend 3 to 5 events a week. So if you can do more, go for it. But it's not about, when you look at an event, it's not about being out in the field 8 hours. You can set up an event that's, at least 2 hours, and then be consistent with that. When I talk about event, it's an activity that involves many people. So let me start taking some questions, and then I'm going to talk about my day yesterday, how my recruiting day was. Good morning, everybody. Thank you so much for being here. I really appreciate all the birthday wishes. Thank you. I feel super, super special today. So since you guys make me feel so special, I'm especially here for you guys today. Okay, let's see. Question. I'm on lead share, and I'm sure you may be referring for regular, but I am referring to regular AMA leads, not paid for. When you contact those leads, are they have to put you? Give me a second, because you wrote a whole paragraph, Denise. My goodness, I can't even see. Okay, when you contact the leads and they have month or so, AMA will take the lead away from you. Okay, how do you keep that lead and someone else? I will, because I couldn't not get. Okay, that's a great question. Girl, you could have just put that in a little paragraph. Don't make me suffer like that. Okay, she's asking, I do purchase leads. However, they are standard leads. They're so-called standard because they're people that are just browsing the internet, and they found Avon, and they say, oh, let me just come in here and see what it's all about. And then, it catches their information and it gets sent to us. Those leads are leads that you just have to work a little harder. She's asking about the leads that the company gives you without having to pay for them. I get them too. And they're no different than the leads that you pay because they are, like I said, they're people that were interested, whether it was in Avon or another earnings opportunity, and they showed up as a lead. So there's a training. The best way, you're asking about, you know, if you're not appointing them and then you lose them and then it goes to the district manager and then somebody else appoints them. I'm going to give you several options with that. You have, once you get a lead and that person is not responding and you know that that person is has that phone number, has that email, but you just cannot get them signed up. If that's not a local lead, reach out to the local district manager. Maybe you know, she's willing to stop by and drop off some information and make sure that you tell your lead that somebody locally is gonna stop by to drop off some more information, a brochure, so they can start their selling. Don't ask me why people don't answer their phone calls, because I don't understand that either. However, the more consistent you are and personable with that lead, the more results you're gonna have. And you know what? If you have to lose it because at the end that person did not answer to you, then, you know, move on. But if you see that a lead has been appointed after you have been working with that lead, you have an option to call leadership to let them know that that lead belongs to you. You have to do that within 7 days and have that lead call themselves. And what I usually do to make sure that that happens, I put them on a three-way call. So I call leadership and then that person is on the line assuring that, yes, they want to be part of your team. And then Avon will grant you that and put it on your team. So is that, did that answer your question? I wanted to be sure that it was clear. Yes. So, you know, it's a different, like when I get a lead, as soon as I see the message, I go into Alma, I send them an email. If I cannot call them right away, then I just send them an email. That gives me time to, you know, go ahead and contact all of them at the same time. So I hope that that answer what it is that you were asking, Denise. And okay, so let's there's not any other questions. Let's continue to how my day was yesterday. We had a Magic Bus event yesterday. As you already know, we have our own event bus. And we call it Magic Bus because it was a program that Avon had a few years ago. Yes, yes, you just have to continue the follow-up. You have to if you continue the follow-up, Denise, you will see that you know, that lead is not going to go away. So you know, just quick emails and keep postponing the days. That way, I have some leads that they're not ready to sign up for months. So I just continue to leave them there and continue the follow-up and send them messages. Hey, look, I just wanted to know that I'm here. If you have any questions, you know, call me. How can I help you get started? How can I build that confidence so you can start your business right away? So, you know, be yourself, not so much, you know, like by the book. Just be you. Hey, just wanted to, you know, to find out if everything's going well and this and that. That touch, and put them on Facebook, put them on your social media so that they can see what you do, okay? So back to the Magic Bus. We call it the Magic Bus because it was a program that was very successful when Avon put it into play. We loved the Magic Bus, and when we saw it, we fell in love, and our team fell in love with the idea of the Magic Bus. And we said, Carlos and I said, "So what do you think?" And I said, and I told them, "I want one." So back then, we had saved up enough money to build a pool, and he said, "Okay, do you want to build the pool at the house, or do you want a magic bus?" And then he said, and then I said, "I am on my working years. We are in our working years, and let's just get the bus." And we did. It was a lot of investment. We got ex the exact same bus from Mercedes-Benz. Brand new from the dealer, and we wrapped it up with our own wrap. We put the awning exactly the same way that Avon had it. And the bus went to work. It probably took about 2 months to get it all going and pick the wrap and everything else and the graphics and all of that that we wanted. So, I said, "What do you mean, definitely a pool? No pool." That bus is making us money to get the pool. So we said, "Okay, we're gonna get our own bus," and we did because our team was so excited while we're doing the Magic Bus events. We had three different buses. In one day, our team was in different areas, and we brought 125 appointments in 3 days and 2 days of events. So total was 125 appointments with 2 days events and three different buses that different teams went to different area. So I said, "Well, definitely that's amazing." What I did before the bus got here, I trained my team to do the Magic Bus event in a tailgating environment. So I basically took them tailgating. And we set up, we did it for 2 weeks. We were tailgating for 2 weeks straight, just bringing everybody that was gonna participate in the Magic Bus. And we just trained how to talk to people, how to approach people, how to find their why, to ask questions, how to get them involved in the business and convert them into a representative. And it worked. Our team did extremely, extremely great. The Magic Bus events are really a more involved event. It has a you're doing a bigger setup. Of course, driving the bus, it's gas money, a lot of diesel money, but it's the same concept as you will do a tailgating or a tent event. It's just that the bus is big, it attracts a lot of people, it has the graphics, it's easy to set up, but it's no different than doing a tailgating and doing a tent event. So you guys, if you don't have a magic bus, doesn't matter. Just use a tent or your car to do your events, okay? And that's what we did. And we have had it. We've had it had the bus since 2012. So it's been December of 2012. So it's been a great blessing for us that we're able to have it. And we did an event yesterday. This place that we went to, the last time that we went to, it was dead, like DEAD, dead. But we said, okay, we really don't have another place to go set up because we didn't have permission, and we need permission for the bus because we don't want to set up and then have to pick up. The same thing for a tent. If you are setting up a tent, you need permission. So if you are setting up with just your car, you don't need permission for tailgating. If you're asked to leave, just pick up and leave. So we went to this area, and it was busy. It started slow, and it started to get busy and busy. It was my husband and I, and I was training one new representative that came from another team leader on our team. And you know, we were just there, basically my husband and I, because she just got started and she needed to learn what it is that we did. So we did great. We signed up one person in the spot. Then we had 15 appointments already set up, people that were gonna sign up online or that we would go to their house to make the appointment. And the new representative signed up one yesterday as well. One of the appointments that she took, she actually signed the person up after the event online. She did it online with her phone, met with her, and did the appointment. She's getting her kit through the mail. And then we're just gonna have to follow up with the rest of the leads, because there were people that said yes to Avon. So even though we didn't do the appointment on the spot, they were in a hurry. Some of them were taking the day, you know, the time to go and have lunch. So they really didn't have time. So it was successful. We're planning to go back Friday and Saturday. And then Sunday is my follow-up day. So you guys, I'm doing these videos. I took the time to do them. I'm not sure if I'm gonna continue to be live after Sunday, because you know, it just takes a little bit of time in the morning to do these videos and then head out to your day. But I committed myself to this week to give you information about events, field time, how to be out there, finding your team members, how to be consistent. And I really hope that you have taken all these videos, and if you have to watch them over and over again, they all relate a different message. So make sure that you watch them. They're posted on my timeline so you can share them, and that you can continue to work your business with consistency, and that this week, by putting into plan recruiting week, that you build the momentum that you need for your business. Once you build your momentum, everything is gonna be easier, because you already know exactly what to do and how to do it. It's gonna be instantly. Even if you're shy, you will just do it, because it's just in you. You've done it so many times that it's just in you. I would like to see pictures and videos of everyone who is participating, and I hope everyone is, on the National Recruiting Week. Use the hashtag National Recruiting Week so that everything can go into that special room and we can all see the videos. I want to thank Avon Wings for the job that they're doing. They're doing excellent with, you know, by taking their team and developing their team like I have taught them. They are doing an amazing job. I'm looking at them and their pictures, how they're in the field with their team or the district managers. I'm really proud of you guys. So keep going. Continue to build your business with consistency. Never give up. Make sure that whatever it is that you do it because you want to. You do it because you like to do what you do, because it's your future. So as you already know, my goal is to become a millionaire with my Avon business, and that's why I work so hard. It's all about sacrifices. Even if you have to say, and you know, when you talk about sacrifices, it's not like you feel bad when you do it. It's about prioritizing. And yesterday, what we did after the event, it was really, really hot. And we liked the beach. So what we did after the event, we had already our stuff in the magic bus, and we went to the beach. We went fishing. So it's not like you have to put everything aside. It's combining, you know, the things that you do to have fun, also to celebrate. If you're going out and you're having a successful day, then at the end of the day, celebrate. And believe me, a successful day doesn't have to be 30 appointments. A successful day can be you just getting out there, reaching out to people, talking to people, and coming home and to celebrate. So that's what we did yesterday. We went to the beach and we went fishing at the beach, and we had a great time. When I talk about sacrifices, it's about you sticking to your schedule. And that took a long time for me to do. A lot of people know that Carlos works shifts. So he's a firefighter, he's a career firefighter. And on his time off, he works with me, and he also drives the magic bus. So when he's home, he wants my attention. He wants to be with me. So it, you know, sometimes he came home and I had events, I had appointments, and then he would tell me, let's go out on the boat. And I love the outdoors. If I can just be outside the whole day, I'm very happy. I love the beach. I love to fish. The only thing I don't do is hunt. I don't like hunting. I don't like killing animals. But I love to be outdoor. And then a lot of times I had to say, no, I can't. He was upset many times because he wanted me to go. And I had to have the discipline to say no. But then he saw that he was doing it so often that we came up with a plan. He told me that, to let him know when I would be available so that I can put it on my calendar and we can set up a day together. And that's what I did. I always said, look, at least tell me 2 days before so that I can, you know, I can tell you if it's okay for this day, and so that I can plan myself to catch up for the other days. So that's what we do. And, you know, it was difficult to be able to say no, to be able to say yes to an Avon event and no to a fishing trip. So, yeah, sometimes there were fishing trips, like all out fishing trips. So you guys, look at your business, work with consistency. This is the message today. Kathy said, do you catch any fish? he catch two catfish, but we don't eat those. And they are saltwater catfish. So there's not a lot of meat in them unless they're like big. And the saltwater catfish, I've never seen them that big. But we do love the freshwater catfish and the tilapia. They just have to be a big fish so you can get some meat out of it. So yes, you guys, have fun with your business and enjoy your journey, everything that you do. Thank you all for tuning in live and for all the birthday wishes. I will continue to say thank you throughout the day, to all the pictures and the things that you're posting on my timeline. It's easy to say no to a husband, but you can't say no to kids. Well, you know, it's funny that you said that, because my kids also had a big part of that. I was blessed to be able to be in at their events and their school activities, and I don't cancel any events whatsoever. If I have it on my calendar, it is happening. I don't care what anybody says. My kids know that I work from home and that I own my own business. I look, when someone cancels on me for an event, I immediately ask myself this question. Okay, would that person have canceled if they had a job that they have to go to and that job tells them, if you are absent one more time, you lose your job, okay? And 99.9%, my question is no, they don't have the commitment. They are not committed enough. So look at your commitment level. I'm telling you, I have gone to events that I have been feeling really sick. I don't get sick often, but I just wasn't feeling well. And I went and I was just as happy as if I was good to go. But I will not cancel on anybody, anything. If it's on my calendar, I'm going to do it. So you guys, before you decide to cancel on your team leader, on your team, on your events, on your work, ask yourself this question, okay? And write it down because this is important. And if you have to look at your mirror and say, okay, Milagros, let me ask the question of the day. Why am I not going to the event today? If I had a job and my boss told me that if you are absent one more day, you will lose your job, would you still be absent? And would you still be absent for this event? So look at it, because I know that a lot of you have no kind of discipline to say, you know what, I have to do this because it's on my calendar. And you know what, you don't have the discipline because you think that by you having your own business, you can do whatever it is that you want to do. Yes, it's true, but you know what, you also have to pay the consequences, because having your own business requires a lot of hard work, a lot of commitment, and a lot of saying no to distractions, and a lot of just doing what you have to do to make it happen. And you know, it's all about your attitude. You can say, I'm going to this event and I'm mad that I couldn't cancel, or you can say, I'm working on my millions and I am doing this event because it's scheduled. Whether your husband, your kids, your family, anybody tells you, you know, leave what you're doing and do it. You gotta build your future, you guys. You have to stay focused. You must do what's necessary for you to build your business. You don't have to go crazy. You just have to have the commitment. And with commitment comes momentum. And once you have that momentum, everything will just come into play. Okay? Very good point. Yes. Sorry, kids, I will be saying Jasmine, you're too much. Thank you so much, Barbara, for joining me. Thanks for sharing that. Yes, that is true. And don't get frustrated because your team cancels them. It happens all the time to me. And you know what? I ask myself that question. That's going to help you, okay, to decide if you're putting your cookies in this person or you're putting your cookies in this person. Or if you put in a little bit of cookies on this one and a little bit on this one and a little bit of this one and a lot on this one. You have to look at their level of commitment. And if someone cancels on you, just make sure that you ask yourself that question. If their boss would tell them that if she misses one more day, that she will be fired, would you still have canceled this event? It works, I'm telling you, it works for me. And then 99.999 is no, the level of commitment is not there. So I already know what to do next. My next is, okay, I ask them the question, and if the question is yes or no, then I decide if I need to be putting in more time with that person or move on to another person. And I have no problems moving on. Believe me, I have moved on many times. So it's in me. Find the courage that you need to say, I've had it. And build your business, find your superstars, find the people that want to be part of your business because they want to, not because you're making them or providing all the amenities and the fun so that they can stay. No, they're not working for me. They're not working for you. They're working for themselves. And until you don't realize that, you're going to have many heartaches. So commitment, you guys, is that level, is the message of today's video, and building momentum. Do the right things consistently and for many years, and you will see that your life, your business will all fall into place. The minute you don't see that you're being consistent or you're doing the right things, then analyze what it is that you can do to change that. Okay? So thank you so much. See you on the next video tomorrow and Friday. You still have like Friday, Saturday, and you have 3 more days of videos with me. So tune in from 8 to 9, any of that time frame. I'm going to be live. You can ask questions. Write down your questions. Use National Recruiting Week hashtag. And I hope to see you guys out there in the field promoting and making it a beautiful field day as many times as you can during the week, but at least 3 to 5 days a week. See you guys. Bye. Estás mi luz.